Today I am going to tell you about the examination of the cornea. In this I will be covering the size, shape, surface, sheen, transparency, corneal vascularization, corneal sensation, back of cornea, corneal endothelium and bimicroscopic examination. The size, anterior surface of the normal cornea is elliptical with horizontal diameter of 11.7 mm and vertical diameter of 11 mm. Abnormalities of in size can include microcornea, in which the anterior horizontal diameter of the cornea is less than 10 mm. Cornea size may decrease in a abnormality known as chasis bulbi. Megalic cornea is a condition in which the anterior diameter of the cornea is the shape of the cornea. The normal cornea is like a watch glass with uniform posterior curve in its central area. Abnormalities can include crepe globus. It is a ectopic condition in which cornea becomes thin and bulges out like a globe. Crepe conus. It is also an ectopic condition in which cornea becomes cone-like. Cornea plana. It is a condition in which cornea becomes flat. This condition can result due to severe hypotony and chasis bulbi. Now talking about the surface of the cornea, the normal corneal surface is smoothness of corneal surface is disturbed due to abrasion, ulceration, ectatic stars and facet. We can examine the surface of the cornea by using placido disc. It is a disc which consists of alternate white and black circles. In this what we do that we make the patient to see in the whole of the disc, and if the cornea of the patient is sharp, normal, then we will get an image like this. In this sharp image will be get without any distortion. Now if there is any deformity in the surface of the cornea, then image will become distorted like this, and we will get irregular corneal surface. Next is sheen. Normally cornea is a bright shining structure. Sheen of the cornea is lost in dry eye condition. Transparency. Cornea is a transparent structure, but it is lost in corneal edema, corneal opacity and corneal ulcers. Examination for corneal ulcer can be done by microscopic examination before and after fluorescein staining to note the size, shape, depth, floor and edges. Corneal vascularization. Normally cornea is an avascular structure, but it may become vascularized in many diseases. Corneal sensation. To test corneas, cornea is richly supplied by nerves. Sensitivity of cornea is diminished in herpetic keratitis, leprosy, diabetes mellitus. To test the corneal sensation, what we do is that we take the patient to look ahead. The examiner touches the corneal surface of the patient with a cotton wick and observes the blinking response. Now if the cornea is normal, then we will get a brisk reflex closure of the eyelid. In this test, we always compare the effect with that of an opposite side. Back of the cornea should be examined for keratic precipitates. These generally we get in uveitis. Corneal endothelium can be examined with specular microscope. Cell density in adult is 3000 cells per mm cube, which decreases with the advancing age. Bimicroscopic examination can be done after staining of a cornea with vital stain. The most commonly used stain is fluorescein staining, in which cornea is done with one drop of 2% aqueous solution of the fluorescein stains. Area denuded of epithelium due to abrasion or corneal ulcer become brilliant green. Next we can use LCM blue stain. It stains the excess mucus selectively, example in keratoconjunctivitis sica. Another stain we can use Rose Bengal stain. In this 1% stain we use and disease and devitalized structure is become stain the cells red. This Rose Bengal stain is irritant, so before using this stain we put 2% xylocaine solution. You can see this is a corneal ulcer which is seen in fluorescein staining. And this is the herpetic herpes simplex keratitis.
Shape can see also.
slit lamp examination of the cornea, in which we can see anterior stroma, posterior stroma, tear film, endothelium, anterior chamber, eyelet, can be seen. Thank you.